the East India Company establishes power over India. Aurangzeb was the last Mughal ruler. After his death in 1707, many Mughal governors and zamindars took his authority and established kingdoms. In the 60s, the East India Company acquired a charter from the ruler of England, Queen Elizabeth I. English ships sailed down the west coast of Africa around the Cape of Good Hope. The fine qualities of cotton and silk produced in India had a big market in Europe. The first Indian factory was set up on the banks of the river Hugli in 1651. By 1696, it began building a fort around the settlement. 2 years later, it threatened Mughal officials into giving the company zamindar rights over their villages. One of these was Calicut, which later grew into the city of Calcutta or Kolkata as it is known today. It also persuaded the Mughal Empire, Aurangzeb, to issue a firman granting the company the right to trade duty free.
When Alawardi Khan died in 1756, Sirajul Dah became the Nawab of Bengal. The company was worried about his power and keen on a puppet ruler who would willingly give trading concessions and other privileges. The areas of conflict between the company and the Nawabs of Bengal were: the Nawabs demanded large tributes for the company's right to trade, denied it any right to mint coins, and stopped it from extending its fortification, and the British started to oppose it. Sirajullah asked the company to stop meddling in the political affairs of his dominion, stop fortification, and pay the revenues. On hearing the news of the fall of Calicut, company official in Madras sent forces under the command of Robert Clive. Finally, in 1755, Robert Clive led the company's army against Sirajullah at Plassey. One of the main reasons for the defeat of the Nawab was that the force led by Mir Jafar, one of the Sirajullah's commander, never fought the battle. Clive had managed to secure his army. Mysore had grown in strength under the leadership of powerful rulers like Hyder Ali and his famous son Tipu Sultan. Mysore controlled the profitable trade of the Malabar coast, where the company purchased pepper and cardamom. By 1857, the company came to exercise direct rule over about 63% of the territory and 78% of the population of Indian subcontinent.